Pillow Talk. What's happening, everyone? It's good to see you. So, long day. Very, very long day. Oh my gosh. Lots of things happening. It was really an exciting thing, actually, because we had live streaming 2016 today for AVA Live Radio, and it was the first one. And the Shadow Web did so great. And we had such a nice talk. We talked about all kinds of stuff, especially, getting over one period in your life and moving to the next. And I thought that that was a really, really great chat that we were able to have because we all go through these transitions, right, in our lifetime. And as we move from month to month and year to year, it's one of those things where you have to go with the flow, and you have to hopefully find what you're passionate about and what you really love to do and work towards that. And if you can find stuff like that, what we were talking about today on the show was that if you can find that place, then you can just accomplish anything that you set your mind to. And not only that, but if you feel like you're going in the wrong direction or you're leading, your life in not the way that it's going to be healthy for you or make you happy, or you're maybe making your relatives unhappy, the people that love you unhappy, then if you find what it is that you love to do and you're passionate about it, then you can make all of those changes happen. And I like talking about that today. That was really cool. It was nice. It was a good surprise. And I kind of knew I was going to go down that road with him because I know his history, but I was just happy to be able to get on the stream and actually do it. And thank you for the hearts, everyone, and all the love. I appreciate that. I think it's great. I am right now, so I'm doing a live cast for YouTube and also Periscope as well as Facebook. So we're kind of multitasking at the same time. And this is Pillow Talk. So Pillow Talk basically is us chatting about real life topics and things that are going on in our lives. So please don't hesitate to make a comment and let me know what it is that you're going through. And let's talk about it for sure. Because what else is there? You know what I mean? If you can't talk with people and you don't find people that will hang out with you and chat about things that are really going on in your life, then what else is social media for? A lot of live streaming. I know. I am doing a lot of live streaming. It is a ton. I told you this year would be my live streaming year for sure. So I'm glad you guys are a part of it, and I'm glad you guys are all here. You know what? I promised something, didn't I? I promised this. I promised one of the chapters in Don't Sweat the Small Stuff. Peter Cameron says, "You are awesome. I love this idea. I have to run." I will be doing this a few nights a week, at least, I would think. But you'll get the heads up, so just follow me on the channels, and that way you guys won't miss the pillow talks. But they will be replayable too. Some of them, I think. Some of them. You can't beat pillow talk. I know. I know. Isn't that the truth? You guys are so funny. All right, so here's the chapter that I opened it to today. And I just randomly choose chapters out of this. I don't know if you guys remember this, but we were doing it like months ago when I was on radio tour, and we just kind of randomly chose topics, just a page. So I have never read this book from cover to cover. I just keep turning to chapters that I haven't read before. And sometimes, even if I read them again, I get a completely different meaning out of it, or we start thinking about a completely different thing. So here's this one. This one is ask yourself the question, will this matter a year from now? And it has a lot to do, if you notice, with what I was talking about. I was talking about earlier on the show, I was talking about just making sure that whatever it is that you're doing, you have the confidence to do it, and it's not something that anybody can deter you from doing. Because there will be people that will come in and out of your life as you try and reach those goals and you try and reach for the stars and accomplish all of your dreams, there will be people that will come in and they will try and take that away from you, or they will get jealous of it, or they'll, you know, say something that will knock off your focus. And I just don't want that to happen. And I'm really, really good at staying focused when people are, you know, and are coming up there. Hard for anyone else. Sometimes it is. It's very, very hard, you know? I mean, you don't realize until somebody shakes your core how hard it is to stay on focus. A lot of times what will happen is you'll be going along really great, and then you'll read one bad comment online and it will just hit you in the wrong way at the wrong time, and bam, your whole world just seems to fall apart. And sometimes if you're not really, really confident about what you're doing, you can literally turn around and change your direction, especially if you have doubts. If you have doubts and somebody puts that little comment in there, you can turn around and it can change your whole course. And that's the bad thing, because you could have been, I mean, in a year of really, really hard work, you could have accomplished everything that you ever set out or dreamed to. And I don't want to see that happen, you know? I don't want to see that happen to anybody that is on my network or that hangs out with me, because I know how that can be, and you don't want to waste even 1 year of your time, you know? So, okay, so this is, will this matter a year from now? And this really, really has to do with what I'm saying. Almost every day, I play a game with myself that I call Time Warp. Hey there, Jason. I made it up in response to my consistent, erroneous belief that what I was all worked up about was really important. And I have such a good story to tell you guys about this. Hang on. To play Time Warp, all you have to do is imagine that whatever circumstances you are dealing with isn't happening right now this year. Hey there. They simply ask themselves, is this situation really as important as I'm making it out to be? Once in a great while, it may be. But a vast majority of the time, it simply just is not. Whether it be in an argument with your spouse, child, your boss, a friend, a mistake or a lost opportunity, a lost wallet, a work-related rejection, a sprained ankle, chances are a year from now, you just aren't going to care, and you're just not going to remember it. It will be one more irrelevant detail in your life that you simply just don't miss. While the simple game won't solve all your problems, if you give an enormous amount of needed perspective into any situation, I find myself laughing at things that I used to take far too seriously. Now, rather than using up my energy feeling angry and overwhelmed, I can use it instead on spending time with those that I love, engaged in creative thinking, and focusing on my goals. Isn't that awesome? Now tell me, when you hear that everything just doesn't fall into place and make sense, right? I mean, now think of how unimportant all the haters are, and think of how unimportant all of the nasty comments are that you might get on the internet. Or think of how unimportant that fight is that you had like a month ago or a year ago that you don't even remember right now. I mean, let me tell you a story. A few months ago, I would say 7 months ago, I got in a really bad fight with my husband, and I recorded it. I recorded him being silly. And I was so upset at that time, you know, I was so upset. And I remember, and then we just played it, and I can still remember the feeling of being upset and frustrated and just feeling like, oh my gosh, you know, this is just a horrible situation and a horrible thing to go through. And then when I watched the video the other day, I laughed hysterically. I mean, it was so funny, and all I kept thinking is, why did it bother me so much then? Because you know what? It just doesn't really matter all that much. You know what I mean? I shouldn't take it that seriously. And I find that a lot of that type of thing happens in life. You know, it happens in your careers. It happens with indie artists when you put something creative out there, or any artist when you put something creative out there. You find that People are going to love it and people might not love it. And if you have a small amount of fans, you're probably going to have a large majority of people that absolutely love what you do. But if you have a lot of fans, you're going to hit, just the odds are going to be stacked up, not against you, but just that maybe one in a thousand people might be one of those crazy, crazy people that just has to be miserable and wants to make you miserable too. And they point out the negatives of anything that you're trying to do. And that can really shake your core. But if you look at it like this, that the things that we get upset about today just aren't really that important. And they just don't affect you a year from now after you've forgotten them, then you realize that you just can't sweat the small stuff. You just have to relax and enjoy yourself and make yourself happy and find ways to live each and every day like it was your first and your last day. But just know that you have a dream and you have something that you really want to accomplish in life and a goal, whatever that may be. And it could just be to be the best friend or the best daughter or the best son or the best wife or the best husband or the best employee. It could be any of those things. It could be that you're going to be the best entrepreneur, the best indie artist. And that's what you live for. You live for the good relationships, the good times that you have, the great memories that you're going to be having from this day on, hopefully, after you don't sweat all the small stuff. And just remember, nothing is that important to get that angry about. So just smile and walk through it. Walk through the bad comments and just move through any negative energy that might be in your life. All right, guys. Well, I hope you liked Pillow Talk tonight. That's my advice. I watched a couple of your videos and you give awesome advice. Thank you. Thank you so much. I'm so glad you like it. Thanks for that. I appreciate it. I try to. I mean, you know, basically my advice just comes from reading something and then having a thought about it, you know, and trying to stay positive. Because I realize that if you're gonna pursue your dreams and you're gonna try and accomplish things, and you know, if it's a big goal, it's not always gonna be easy. There are gonna be things that stack up against you, but you have to kind of try and weigh and balance it. So I just kind of use common sense based on what I've been through. And I've been through quite a lot of things. And as you get older, you go through even more things, right? And as you go through more things, you have this like knowledge of learning from the previous times before. And I just try to speak from the heart. So I'm glad that you guys really enjoy it.
Do you want me to read? Yeah.
You know what this is? This is, it's called Autumn State of Mind. I wrote this like years ago, like 12 years ago. Common sense is absent in daily life. And I look, yeah, it is, isn't it? This is Pillow Talk. Jacob, welcome. I'm glad you're here. Yeah, it is. It is. You know why? Because people do things like out of emotion, you know? And that's what reading a negative comment is. The minute you read it, you could get fiery, you could get sad, you could get, it's emotion. And it's not really coming from the place of, I can respect the comment and maybe see what they mean by it. You take it to heart and you think that it just means you need to shut down, and that's just not the way to do it. Those are pretty pillows. Thank you. You like my pretty pillows for Pillow Talk? My pillow is right here. You guys are so funny. I love it when you comment. All right, so what are we reading? We're reading The Mirror?
Yeah.
Okay, this is one of the poems that I wrote a long time ago. It's actually a poetry book. I made it for my mom forever ago, like 10, 12 years ago. And this one's called The Mirror. Yes, those pillows are pretty too. Okay, so The Mirror is simply this. Looking in the pictured mirror, never did I see things clearer. Eliminated by the light, I froze in time to view my life. And as I looked upon the frame, I knew right then to never change. And that's The Mirror. So if you're happy with yourself, then you should never change. You just have to stay happy with yourself. And you have to not have regrets. I remember when I wrote this, I remember thinking, you have to not have regrets. That was awesome. Thank you. I'm so glad you like it. That was Morning New Jersey is commenting in my comment field right now. What? I don't know. I don't know. I'm not telling you, right? I'm not telling you how old I was when I wrote it.
You were young.
So, thank you for the mention. You're welcome. You're welcome. Hey, Jean, how are you? Hello. Nice to see you. Thank you so much for the comments, you guys. But yeah, it's basically that you have to be happy with yourself no matter what. Happy Women's Day. It is. It's Women's Day, isn't it? Thank you. And that's the kickoff of my pillow talk. I think so, yeah.